Hello everyone, welcome to the Engineers for Civil YouTube channel. Today topic is how to calculate capacity demand ratio of column and what is the capacity demand ratio. Consider if you create or if you design a column for a load 100 kN. The 100 kN is the demand of the structure. Okay, demand of the structure, and the capacity of the column. You have to try to design a column a capacity more than 100. Okay, if the capacity is less than the demand, the structure is failed. So you try to design a structure capacity more than demand. So if you create a column with 200 kN capacity, it means the ratio of capacity demand is 2 greater than 1. Is capacity demand ratio is 1, it means it's economical and safe. If capacity demand ratio is greater than 1, it's uneconomical but safe. If capacity or demand ratio is less than 1, it means the structure is failed. So how to calculate this in ETAP? Let's start. First of all, we have to create a model, or we have to create a single column and apply load and check the capacity demand ratio. Okay, we choose default property, default concrete member, and this is the column. We choose concrete column from here. Okay, and draw here. And let's create a support, fixed support at the base. And the applied joint load movement and vertical force. Okay, vertical force in Z direction, like minus 20 kN, and movement in X direction 10 kN. Okay, we have applied two loads. Now analysis this column, and after analysis check the capacity and demand ratio. So what is the capacity of this column and what is the demand? Demand is 20 kN vertical load and movement is 10 kN. Okay, after this you have to create a combination for design. Add a combination, and we take combination only for dead load, COM1, and go to the design, concrete design, select combination and design, start design. And after design, you have to right click on the structure and go to the interaction curve, but no interaction curve because here something error 000. The law structure is fail and why structure is fail. Let's check. Okay, this is the column and we have to design this column for RCC. Let's extrude this column, check the dimensions. Right clicking on the column, story force, even concrete beam, shear, and top steel, bottom steel. Okay, let's check the define a material of concrete, add new, and Indian concrete M30. Okay, now what we do, we change the concrete material. Something wrong in the material, go to section property, frame section, and we have choose concrete beam, sorry, concrete beam we choose. Okay, so what we do, go to concrete column and select the material M20, M30. Okay, now select the member and assign frame property column, not beam. Column. And okay, now again analysis and design. check for design. Okay, done. Now right click on the column and check interaction curve. And now you can check here from the combination what is the capacity demand ratio, and the capacity demand ratio is 1.125 demand capacity ratio. We're talking about capacity demand ratio, but here demand capacity ratio, it means the inverse of the value. Okay, demand is 100 kilonewton example, and the capacity is also 100 kilonewton. It means the ratio is 1, building is safe and economical. If capacity is less, the ratio is greater than 1. If capacity is more than demand, then ratio is less than 1, and the structure is safe but uneconomical. So in this case, you can see here the green line, dark green line, it means structure is safe but uneconomical, because demand capacity ratio is very less, 0.125. So what we do, we increase this ratio. We have to increase load. So go select the column and assign frame joint load force and modifies 20 to 200, and okay, and again analysis and design and check the demand capacity ratio. In the first part in this YouTube tutorial, we talking about the capacity demand ratio. Per ETAP showing demand capacity ratio, the value is inverse. Okay, right click and check interaction curve, and what the latter value is 1.25, now is 1.25, again 1.25, because due to the vertical load, the vertical load is axially loaded and the compressive strength of the concrete is very high. That's why nothing change. So if we increase the moment, these are the technical terms you can learn through this tutorial. If we increase the moment, then the capacity demand ratio is affected. Okay, we change the moment is 1000 and analysis. Are you understand na? Because the 200 kilonewton load is axially loaded and the compressive strength of concrete is very high, that's why the capacity demand ratio is not changed. If we change the moment 1000 kilonewton, the OS is appear on the column, it means over stress, it means structure is failed. And the curve we check, change the curve color is red, and the value is 1.25, it means 1.25 less the capacity of column. So this is the tutorial about demand capacity ratio. You can check the structure is safe if the reinforcement is showing on the column, but is economical or not economical, you can go to the DC ratio and check the DC ratio. Okay, if you like this video, please subscribe, share and click on bell icon. Thank you very much.